For this, what we need is the following. Soldering iron. I have quite a luxurious soldering iron, but any cheap soldering iron will probably do. I'm using an anti-static mat. That's not exactly needed. These components are fairly easy to deal with, and it's hard to break them with static electricity. As a precaution, you could go over and touch something metal in your house that's grounded, like your radiator, and then start soldering. You need, with the soldering iron, some solder. You will need a pair of clippers to cut the excess wire, and a simple voltmeter. So that's actually all that's needed to build a working computer. So let's move on to the first step, which is actually not building the computer, but checking if the kit is complete. And for this, if you look at chapter 3 in the manual, before you begin, there's a list of all the components. So I will start checking off if we have everything in the kit. So it says I need to have a PCB, present. I need to have certain resistors. And now you can also use the chapter in the manual that describes how all the components look and how to tell the actual values of these components. So resistors have a certain resistance measured in ohms, and they are color-coded onto the components, and the instruction manual will explain how to tell which from which. So let's take a look. These have tiny markings on them, so I probably need some kind of loop to read this, but something that everybody probably has is a mobile phone, and if you take the camera application, that makes a nice loop as well. So I can try and see what's written on here. And it says 104. And if you look in the manual, that means those are capacitors of 100 nanofarads. And I should have 40. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. 20, 22, 25, 27, 29, 31, 33, 35, 37, 39, 40. Check. And we're going to do the whole bag of components like this. Resistors. LEDs, plug, so the components that I have most of are the diodes. So there should be 30 in the kit, but because it's very hard for us to measure out exactly 30 each time, you might find that you have more than 30 diodes. That's not a problem. The excess diodes, do whatever you like with them. Maybe an arts project. I've counted all the components except for the ICs. Now for the ICs, you can do it two ways. You can go and take a look at the list and read all the markings on the ICs to check if you've got them. But you can also look at the printed circuit board, because we've put the ICs in the exact same order in the anti-static foam. So these correspond to each other. So it's quite easy to check if you have the correct amount of components. Now, in the list of components, there is a socket, 40-pin socket, and a second 28-bit socket. Now, it might be that you have separate sockets and ICs. It might be, as in this case, that the ICs are already put into their sockets. So here we have one socket and one IC. And the same goes for this one. The EEPROM is also already in the socket. So to be completely sure, I'm now going to read the markings on the chips and see if they match the list of components.